Well, I can come round straight away. That would be lovely. Thank you. Good. I'll bring the form with me and look forward to seeing you in a little while. Thank you. Bye.
I've always been interested in the history of buildings, and when I realised how near Headstone Manor is, I contacted Jan Strode of the Harrow Museum, and she very kindly offered to take me round the manor house and explain what they're doing.
Hello, Pat.
Hello, Jan. Nice to meet you.
Welcome to Harrow Museum and Heritage Centre. Now, before we go over to Headstone Manor, perhaps you'd like to come in and look at the model, as I think it will make it easier for you to understand.
That's fine. Good idea.
Come in.
Well, Pat, this is how the house looks today.
I see. But there's a canopy over. Is it this bit?
Yes, that's the medieval part of the house. And we've had the roof taken off, ready for restoration, and so we need to protect the building from the weather. And you also have to remember that where you're looking at this front, at one time it was wooden, and the brick was put on at a later date.
Yes.
But yes, we'll go over and we'll be looking at these, the hall, the cross wing, and the tower. And then if we turn it round, we will go round the house, and then we start to come up, more up to date. We start going into the 16th, along here, then the 17th and the 18th century. So the house has had quite a long history through time, and it varied in each of its phases.
Yes.
It's quite a fascinating structure.
Yes, indeed it is. And you can see all the different ages.
That's right, as each different piece of the roof line has been put in. Mm. And then as you come right round, you come to what we would call the modern part, but it's really only 16th century onwards.
Yes.
Quite a nice little outshot here. And then we come right round. This is the existing front door at the moment, which has changed because at one time it used to be here.
And that's the museum now.
This part is open,
yes,
as a museum,
yes,
and we intend gradually, to, as the house is restored, to have room settings of the different periods of the house's history.
Oh,
showing.
Good.
Yes, it just will show the events that have happened in the house and how it has changed. As any modern house changes, with the housewife putting in new windows or fireplaces or whatever.
Yes.
Well, I hope it gives you some idea of what we're about to see.
Yes, lovely.
But you will have to use your imagination where it's being stripped down for renovation.
Of course.
That's right. Yes. Shall we take the model with us to help?
Fine.
We don't have an exact date for this building, but we know that by the 14th century it was the main residence in Middlesex of the Archbishop of Canterbury. It came into public ownership in 1929 and is owned by the London Borough of Harrow. Oh,
this is the 14th century moat. It's square in shape, goes right round the manor house, and it's the only complete moat left in Middlesex.
Well, that's interesting. Where does the water come from?
It's almost static now. It used to run into the River Yeading, but that was separated in 1970. It has a slight overflow to compete with the weather. If we have heavy rain, then it will drain off.
Yes.
And
yes.
So the water does rise and fall a little.
Yes. It's quite clean though, isn't it?
It's not too bad. It does get dirty at times, but it's all part of the life cycle of a moat. Okay.
Fine.
Shall we go into the manor house? I'm afraid there's a bit of a climb under the scaffolding.
Okay.
Before starting the restoration, this canopy and cage had to be erected as protection for the old parts of the building. Now the tiles have been removed from the roof.
Hmm, I see what you mean about a bit of a climb. I can see now why you had to cover this half of the building.
We're standing here, and this is the 14th century hall and cross wing, which runs from there to there. And if you look through, this is the 19th century timber, and you can see the rough timbers of the 14th century roof through there.
Oh, I see, yes.
We'll have a look at the beams in the aisle hall. At some time, the roof was raised, and they had to cut the beams to do this. And you can see through there exactly what happened. In fact, we're standing here to give you some idea of position, and you are looking through that roof. You can also see some beautiful wooden pegs in those beams.
Yeah, great, aren't they?
They really are. Of course, the beams have shrunk a little, which is why the pegs are sticking out so clearly. We're now standing just here at the top of the 17th century tower. This was built in two stages. First, the basement and the lower part were built in the early 17th century, and the upper part and roof were put on at the end of the 17th century.
What on earth have they done here? It looks a bit peculiar.
Well, you know, Pat, even in those days they had jerry builders, and the original roofline finished just here, but started to lean almost immediately. So all they did was add another piece to straighten the building up. By the way, there's an interesting little exhibit you might like to look at here. The cowl hair sticking out from the original plaster, and you can almost tell what colour the cowl was way back from the 17th century.
Yeah. Oh, that guttering looks if it comes through the roof.
It does just that, Pat. When they wanted to get from point A to point B, they didn't mess about. They just went straight through the building.
My goodness.
While we're standing here, we're just here on the model.
Yes.
And you can look down and see the 14th century back door and the 17th century back door and porch, which is this bit sticks out here.
The house looks as if it's falling apart here.
It's doing just that. This is the 17th century part of the tower. This is the 14th century hall, and the two buildings are moving apart. Also, you can see the supporting beam of the hall up there is just a fingertip. And then if you look further down, you can see the old staircase which came out and went towards the garden. That was probably destroyed by fire when the old hall was burnt down, and they just simply blocked the doorway up. The hall continued along here and would have been about twice as wide as it is now. This, of course, we believe was burnt down, and it would have taken this wooden staircase with it. This is one of the most archaeologically interesting windows in the building. It's this one at the base of the tower.
I see, yes.
Now we have three phases of window here. This, we think, is the early 17th century frame. Then we have a later one here, same width as the earlier one. And then an even later one, which is the one you can see now complete.
Oh, so these two are not part of the same window?
No, this one has been just put on, keeping this as a base.
I see.
Right, shall we move on to the back door now? Now we've got a fine close-up of the 17th century back door. It would have had two windows, one either side, plus two panels, probably with carved items set in. It's a particularly fine 17th century back door, showing that the house was owned by a very wealthy family during the 17th century.
Mm. Oh, what's that?
Well, that's the staircase. Do you remember we saw it from the outside of the tower?
Yes.
And you can see it's being supported by those curved beams with a bar running through, and it's suspended. It looks very precarious to us, doesn't it?
It does. Yes.
Anyway, shall we go into the hall?
Fine.
Well, we're now in what remains of the 14th century hall.
And when was this hall put in?
We think at the end of the 17th century, but possibly the beginning of the 18th century.
Were they windows?
We don't think so.
There is evidence that there were painted windows on the outside, and there was no real reason to have windows in this building.
Yeah.
And then if you look further up, can you see that large post with the three branches?
Oh, yes.
Yes, well, that should have a fourth branch going in the opposite direction. And that was what gave us our first clue that this was only part of the building.
Oh, I see.
I don't think we need this. I'll just put it down.
What's behind that panel up there?
Well, that's covering a window from the Archbishop's bedroom. It's 17th, possibly 16th century.
Yes. So there is actually a window behind there?
Yes, there is. It was thought to be horn, but in fact it's glass.
Oh. And would the hall have been panelled?
Yes, there was still some panelling left, and that's been put away for restoration. And there's a 16th century settle, which has also been packed up.
So it will be put back in place eventually?
Yes, we hope to return it to its former glory.
Lovely.
Well, Pat, we're now standing in the 14th century buttery, or what remains of it, and you can see the old window, which shows quite clearly there that that was an outside wall.
Oh, so this was an outside wall and is now an inside wall.
That's right, and if you look through here, you can see the 16th century building, which has been built against it.
Oh.
And there is a lovely curving beam just here. Shall we go on?
Okay.
This is a 14th century back door with the porch beyond.
Is that the original door?
No, this is a replacement, I'm afraid, but the surround is the original.
Oh, yes.
This is a 17th century porch, which we were looking down on from upstairs, and this is the 17th century back door where we were standing just now.
Do we go this way now?
Yes, that's the inside. Now we'll have a look around outside.
The other part is 17th and 18th century, and it houses part of the museum. The museum officer also lives there.
This looks in quite good condition.
This black and white looks quite different from the red brick at the front, doesn't it? You're looking at the only original window remaining in this part of the building. We know that this part was used as a cow shed by the 19th century, and that door could have been used as an entrance to a hayloft.
This is what I call the more modern part of the manor house, and we have our 30s room settings through that black front door. We have a 30s living room and a 30s kitchen. And you remember I told you this was a timber framed house originally?
Yes.
We can tell exactly when the bricks went up by that date there, 1772. And the W's are the Williams family who lived in the house at the time, and probably their relatives or employees. And you see the names go right the way along on that line.
Oh, yes. When I came in here, I noticed the sign here.
Oh, that's the Sun Insurance sign, 1797.
Goodness, and they're still in existence, aren't
yes,
they?
Yes, they're now the Sun Alliance Company. And you'll notice we have some fine 16th century chimneys up there.
Oh, yes, they're lovely.
Yeah, they do seem to lean over, don't they?
A bit.
Well, Pat, now you've seen round the old manor, I hope you'll be interested in becoming a friend of the museum.
Well, I'll certainly think about it, and I'll let you know.
Well, that's the end of the tour. I hope you enjoyed yourself.
It's been wonderful. Thank you very much indeed for spending so much time with us. You've done so much work there, it's absolutely marvellous.
Well, there's still quite a bit to be done, as you saw. But if you know anyone who's got some money to give us, please pass their names on.
I'll do that.
But it's been lovely having you
yes.
here.
Yes, thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.